It's Halloween. Everybody make a scene. Trick or treat. Tell your neighbors on the telephone.
Well, that movie is one way to get your little ghosts and goblins into the spooky holiday spirit. Another way is with some fun-filled crafts. And we have Karima Henry from the blog Crafting a Fun Life back with us today to share some Halloween crafts that are so cute and scary. So welcome back to the show, Karima.
Thanks for having me again.
Yes, we always have so much fun with you. Three Halloween crafts that you can do with those little hands, right?
Yes, or big hands.
Or big hands, I like that. So where should we get started, Karima?
So we're gonna start with our Frankenstein first.
Okay, oh, that's cute.
I mean, seriously, how cute is this?
I love it. What do you need for this craft?
So what you need is paper plate, of course.
We have that at home, right?
Exactly.
Love it.
You know, grab that. Some construction or cardstock paper.
Okay.
Glue, of course, diesel. Wiggly eyes.
Yes.
And a black marker.
Okay, I love it.
That's it. And if you have a child that's not a fan of glue, you can use tape as well.
Okay, good idea.
Because I know you have some kids that have sensory issues, so
okay.
You can use tape as well for
I
that.
I like that you think about that.
Of course.
Yeah.
So what you need, I took care of already.
Thank you for painting this.
Yes. Plus, I mean, don't want to mess up our manicures.
Right, right. Good call. Oh, yeah, so we have green paint on this paper plate.
Yes, you paint it green first. And then we're going to glue. You can use any kind of glue that you have at home. Glue stick, liquid glue.
Okay.
We're going to glue our hair on there first.
I like it.
Okay, this one is...
Man,
doesn't want to come out. I mean, seriously.
Let's imagine. So I'm going to be the kid. Oh, wait. Some of the glue came out, so we're good there.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm going to tape the other side, so I'm the kid who doesn't like the glue, too.
You can tape it. It may take a while for it to dry. That's fine.
Right. And tape is faster.
Yes. And then you can add your little eyebrow, unibrow.
Little unibrow.
Nothing wrong with that.
Ain't nothing wrong with unibrow. Rock it out, kiddos.
Add that on there. And then underneath the unibrow, you can add the eyes. If you don't have these at home, it's okay. You can draw them on.
Okay.
You can use your marker to draw it for the kids if you don't have it.
Okay.
Like this. That's a little black eye. That's fine. And then we're gonna add our little face. I have these on my website where you can print it out yourself and cut them and then glue it.
How cute. So,
Frankenstein is not always
smiling.
Upset. I'm sure he's happy when he's eating something. So you can add a smiley face or an angry face, whatever your child wants. And then you add your bolts.
Mine
so you just, you can use black or you can use gray paper and just glue it together. And either tape it
or glue it underneath. I see what we're doing there.
And then when you're finished, it will look like this.
Look at that. How cute.
And did you know that on October 28th is Frankenstein Friday? So this would be the perfect craft for that.
Okay, I like it. We learn new things with you every time you're on the show. Okay, up next. I think this is my favorite one.
We have our wooden boo sign. You can get this from the Dollar Tree. The kids, I mean, of course, they're not gonna decorate it like this.
Look how cute. That is,
this is something you can definitely do with your children at home.
Okay.
You can paint it any color.
So maybe mom, dad, grandparent,
right? Get the whole family in here.
So grandparent, you do this for your decor around the house,
exactly.
And then you get the kids involved and just keep those hands busy. Okay, what do we need to do here?
So you just need paint. You can use sequins, glitter. I have some eyeballs for us.
Oh, that's cute.
So all you have to do is paint it any color you want, let your kids pick it out. I suggest acrylic paint.
Okay.
For multi-surface.
Why?
Because I think it'll last longer.
I see. Okay.
So I'll definitely choose that. And then you're just gonna glue your eyeballs on there.
Okay.
If you have bats, you can glue that on there. If you have spiders, anything you want. And then, of course, I went with the sequins because I'm extra.
Love it. Love a little sparkle.
So you can do that. And because I pay attention to detail because I'm extra, I use this little instrument. So it takes longer, but it gives my kids something to do so we're not like rushing through the craft.
Let me ask you.
And they can work on their fine motor skills with this as well.
So this clear glue
yes.
is going to be fine. So you can kind of just like
spread it
out.
Yep, and it'll dry clear. It'll dry just like this. Yes, perfect.
Okay, got it.
Look at you.
You know,
see, this is how you earned
here.
Your certificate for crafting.
I've grown by leaps and bounds since that.
I'm so proud of you.
That leprechaun trap.
We won't talk about that.
Okay, no, we won't share that. If you missed it, I'm so sorry for you.
You didn't miss anything. We're moving
moving on up.
Let's move on up. Let's move on up. Like the Jeffersons. I like
yes.
it. Okay, so there we go.
Oh, yours is so pretty. I love
voila.
It. Good job. So something next. Simple. And next we have our thumbprint. Ghost pumpkin.
That's so cute.
If you're like me, I'm not a fan of carving pumpkins.
I'm not even.
And you can keep it simple, and if you don't want to deal with paint, I got you.
Do a little glove.
Use a glove.
Put a little glove on. MJ, right?
Okay. So you use your thumbprint, your fingerprint.
Okay.
You don't need a lot, and just stamp around the pumpkin.
Okay.
Yes, make the little ghost.
This is actually cute, my goodness.
Yes.
Just a polka dot pumpkin.
And you can do this on those craft pumpkins as well.
Oh, that's
so
a good
So you can
idea.
Use that year round.
Mm,
and then once
like
you're
that.
Finished with that, take those gloves off. Use a Q-tip if you don't have a paintbrush at home.
Look at this mess-free craft.
Exactly, mess-free.
Mm-hmm.
And just make your eye and the mouth a bit.
I like it. Look at this.
So you can see. Boom.
There you go. Well, we've run out of time. This was so cute. But look at that little ghost. Mm. Very cute. Karima, thank you so much for these ideas. We love it. Hey, for more adorable crafts, you can head to her website. There it is on your screen. It is craftingafunlife.com.